is now time to facilitate a distinguished book with the ILF Samanvay Bhasha Samman. This is the fourth year of this prestigious annual award instituted by the India Habitat Center's Indian Languages Festival Samanvay. And this year's recipient is Madhubhagan, or One Part Woman, by Perumal Murugan.
Dear friends, it's my privilege to be here representing the whole jury. I'm sorry that all the members of the jury are not on stage, but they are here in front of me. The Samanvay Award, this is the fourth year of the Samanvay Award, but there has been a transition in the sense that it used to be an individual award, a writer award, and now it has become a book award. And it had some kind of a logic behind it, because earlier awards went to writers who were already well known, well established, whose contributions are known across the country, and for whom this award did not mean much, like Ashok Vajpayee, for example, or Sidagan Mahapatra, who even without this award are so well known and well recognized. So the idea was rethought, and we decided that the award now should go to individual books, which are not necessarily known nationally, so that a writer gets to be known nationally, even though in the case of Perumal Murugan, he got to be known nationally for the wrong reasons. This time we had a cluster of languages that we took into account, and we got nominations in those languages like Tamil and Bengali and Dogri and Marathi and Mizo. And from the nominated works, all of us unanimously found Perumal Murugan's Madhubhagan to be deserving of the award. In fact, we were not politically motivated, even though you may think so. We found that was the best work available to us among the various nominated works for various reasons, because he's a kind of historian of his part of Tamil Nadu. Of Kongu Nadu. He's a lexicographer, a scholar, a major writer, and he has made a major contribution to Tamil literature, particularly Tamil fiction, and also Tamil scholarship, having brought to light a lot of books which had been forgotten, and also having himself contributed to the history of that part of Tamil Nadu. So he is a unique kind of writer, and Chalapathy will say more about the particular novel which won the award, which has been translated as One Part Woman, which I think many of you might already have read. And the novel, the publisher of the novel is here to accept the award. Perumal himself could not make it. He graciously accepted the award and thanked the members of the jury, but for personal reasons he was not able to make it here. So Mr. Kannan represents the writer in some way, because after all it's the publisher who in partly creates the writer. So I would request Kannan to come over here, and also Venkata Chalapathy, who is going to speak a bit about this particular work.
Perumal Murugan has been a friend, has been a respected colleague. He's barely a year older to me, and as Sachi has said, Perumal Murugan is a writer, he's a novelist, he has written short fiction, he has written poetry, he has done lexicography, he has written essays, he's a teacher. One would actually say that he hasn't touched anything that he has not adorned. And he has been writing very consistently. He has avoided limelight all his life. And it is kind of ironic that a person who is very quiet and always is in the background, doing what he is very good at, writing and teaching, now he is in the limelight, he is in the glare of very adverse publicity, and also, of course, very positive publicity. So Madhubhagan, his fifth novel, it marks the second phase of his writing. As I mentioned earlier in the morning, his first set of novels had a very naturalist style. In the second phase of his writing, he was focused, his focus has shifted. He is now exploring the minds of the characters that he is portraying. Madhur Bhagan is especially close to Perumal Murugan because the Madhur Bhagan is one other name of Lord Shiva, who is in the form of Ardhanarishwara, who is half man, half woman. And Tiruchengodu is the abode of Ardhanarishwara, Madhur Bhagan. And that is the place where for a very long time, for centuries, childless couple used to go and pray at the temple of, at the town here at Tiruchengodu, and expect to be blessed with a child. So the theme of the novel itself is this. Many of you, I'm sure, have read it. And I think what this novel has also been ably translated by Anirudh Vasudevan. Very broad outline. The story is, of course, you know, the story is not the novel at all. But for want of a different way of talking about the novel, I'll just lay out the bare outlines of the story. The novel is set sometime in the 1920s or 30s. It is about a couple from the peasant community of Kunguvelalars, Kali and Purna. They have a wonderful conjugal life, and one of the best parts of the novel is that, you know, how Perumal Murugan is able to capture the conjugal happiness of a peasant couple, working peasant couple set some 70, 80, 90 years ago. It's an amazing way in which he has done that. You know, you're reading that the first part of the novel. It's a very short novel. You actually yearn for, you know, that kind of a relationship. You know, you dream of that kind of the closeness and intimacy that he's able to, you know, subtly indicate. But this happiness of this couple, Kali and Purna, is marred by the absence of issues. They don't have children. And in a series of little snippets, Perumal Murugan shows the kind of, stigma that is attached to a barren woman. And those are the moments, you know, which actually, you know, they're really heartrending, not in a very sentimental way, but really, really heartrending. They're very moving. Through the story then, you know, he brings up a long-standing tradition in that region. I know the research that Perumal Murugan did about this particular rite that goes on in the month of Vaigasi. Sometime Vaigasi comes in May to June, and on the 14th day, the full moon day, there is a socially sanctioned ritual where childless women go to this place where milling with lots of young men, and in a socially sanctioned ritual in that carnival, they have the right to choose a partner, obviously a faceless partner, and have a relationship with them and hope to have a child. The children born out of such a relationship are referred to as Sami Kudutha Pillai, and they are accepted within society. Through, you know, very subtle ways, the story, Perumal Murugan talks about the discomfort that Kali has with letting Purna go to this carnival, despite the fact that, you know, he himself has been part of that carnival on more than one occasion when he has been a young man. The novel ends on a very ambiguous but also a pregnant note. When Kali realizes after, you know, he has had a long day, a long night of drinking, and wakes up and actually finds out that, you know, Purna has actually left for that carnival. The rope on the hay rake that he has been lying on slips and falls on the tree and hangs down as a noose. And that's where the story ends. I distinctly remember the moment when I read this novel, and I know this Perumal Murugan's second phase of writing, as the expectation that he builds up in the story, not in a negative sense, but in a very positive sense, without compromising on literary quality, the pace quickens, and I can distinctly still remember, you know, I am on the last page, last but one page of the book, and I know that the novel is going to end in another 20 or 30 lines, and I still can't figure out how the novel is going to end. It is your pulse quickens, and then the novel ends on this note. And I have interacted with so many people who have read this novel, and you know, nobody's sentiments were hurt. You know, in fact, it was actually moved so many people. And in fact, I can talk from my personal experience. I didn't have a child for about 8 years after my marriage. My wife read this book. I have read this book. And, you know, even though I might not live in a situation where I would countenance people, making snide remarks about my wife, even I could empathize with this situation. It is so poignant and moving without being sentimental. And I would end on the note by saying that the tragedy of Perumal Murugan is that he was at the height of his powers, which he demonstrated by writing not one sequel but two sequels, a sliding door kind of two sequels to this novel. He had ideas for at least another 7 or 8 novels, and it is really tragic that he may not continue to write. I can only say that, you know, the jury has made a very wise decision, and I wouldn't expect anything less than that from such a eminent jury. And I'm really happy on behalf of Perumal Murugan that this award has been conferred on his book. I hope that little things like these awards, recognition, everything would perhaps change, not only change his mind, but also the context which impelled him or forced him to take the decision that Perumal Murugan, the writer, would die, and only the humble teacher, P. Murugan, would be alive. I really hope, if not like God, if not within 3 days, I hope Perumal Murugan, the writer, will be resurrected. Thank you very much.
Can I invite on stage the director of India Habitat Center, Sri Rakesh Kaka, who will be presenting the award, before which I will just read the citation for Perumal Murugan. We have a brief citation for Perumal Murugan. I thank the jury for all the help and also for helping me draft this citation. Perumal Murugan is an author of great versatility and a writer of fiction with a rich sense of history. His over 35 books, short stories, novels, poetry, dictionary, folklore, essays provide a veritable cultural map of the dry Kongu region of Western Tamil Nadu. Like all great literature, Perumal Murugan's work is culturally rooted but has deep universal resonances. Madhurubhagan is a rooted and passionate work of fiction that narrates with searing intensity and unsparing clarity the story of a relationship caught between the dictates of social convention and the tug of personal anxieties. Perumal Murugan revels in recording the peasant language of the region, and the Tamil language has been enriched by his writings. The Tamil literary canon has been expanded with the induction of the series of novels and short stories that he has written. Madhurubhagan occupies pride of place in this canon. Madhurubhagan has been translated into English as One Part Woman, translated by Aniruddhan Vasudevan, and published by Penguin in its Hamish Hamilton imprint in December 2013, and was shortlisted for the Crossword Award 2014. A Malayalam translation has been published under the title Arthanarishwaran. Hindi and German translations are forthcoming soon. Madhurubhagan is a powerful work of fiction that is the product of an artist at the height of his creative powers, as Chalapathy so beautifully explained here. In recognition of his singular literary achievement in Madhurubhagan, the duly constituted jury of the India Habitat Center's Indian Languages Festival, Samanvay 2015, confers on Perumal Murugan the ILF Samanvay Bhasha Samman 2015 on this day, the 28th of November 2015. HD to present the citation and the award to Srikant.
Good evening. Let me begin by thanking Team Samanvay, Vani Foundation and the jury for awarding Perumal Murugan. On accepting the ILF Samanvay Pasha Saman, Perumal Murugan sent out a statement that was signed as P. Murugan. In it, he stated that he is now acting as the shadow of Perumal Murugan. Now and on a few occasions in the last year, I have had to step in to speak for the first hollow man of literature, the writer Perumal Murugan. If P. Murugan himself is now a shadow, I feel like a phantom limb. It itched while I watched the majoritarian mafias in action, but restrained myself in the absence of the writer Perumal Murugan. 20 years ago, after reading some of his early writings, I wrote him a letter. We became good friends soon after. I have had the privilege of being his publisher for nearly a decade now. If under normal circumstances, he had asked me to receive an award on his behalf, I would have considered it a honor for me. Today, even if it is definitely an honor, it is also a painful reminder. A reminder that I now have to say Perumal Murugan was, even as he very much is. Perumal Murugan was a prolific writer, poet, research scholar, literary critic and chronicler. I have read him with pleasure and admiration for the last 25 years. In the last 12 months, I have read only his painful emails and gut-wrenching statements. Living in a country where people with hurt sentiments outnumber book readers, I feel my status both as a publisher and a citizen being undermined. I can be a complete publisher only when I can publish the unself-censored writings of Perumal Murugan and many other gutsy writers, and fearlessly, without fear, indulge in what Kalachoodu does best: dissent, provoke, infuriate, and hurt sentiments. Thank you for allowing me to receive this award on behalf of Perumal Murugan.
When I listened to what was happening to him, I was profoundly moved and was so deeply sorry that a great writer of our country had to stop writing under threat and pressure. It looked so ironical, and it gave me a poem called Pardon, which I read out as a kind of tribute to the writer who is absent and who thinks he is dead as a writer. Pardon. Pardon me for what I have written, for what I could not write, because this was written in Malayalam, I'm reading it in translation. Pardon me for what I have written, for what I could not write, what I am likely to write, and what I may never write. Pardon me for the trees flowering, for the flowers fruiting, for having hoarded so much of gold and water and spring inside the earth. Pardon me for the waning moon, for the setting sun, the movement of the living, the stillness of the non-living. Pardon me for filling earth with so much of color, blood with so much red, leaf with forest, rain with sky, sand with star, and ink with dreams. Pardon me for filling words. Pardon me for filling words with so much meaning, dates with so much history, for having hidden today inside yesterday and tomorrow inside today, for creating the creator who fills gestures with dance and nature with symbols. Pardon for the earthquake and the tempest, the wildfire and the raging sea. Earth is a damaged machine. I am not the one to repair it. I am the king without a country, the god without a weapon, life without a tongue. Invent a god that doesn't ask for your head. Invent the fearless man. Invent language, alphabet.